For audience, the Father to Father Bernard, for Mayosi, whom the Lord called and buried us today, that the Lord who called him may give him a place of peace and light. Together with our different intentions, we now begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Jesus Christ and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask grace and merit of mercy, all angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
God have mercy.
God have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
God have mercy.
God have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who brought the Abbot St. Anthony to serve you by the wondrous way of life in the desert, grant through his intercession that denying ourselves, we may always love above all things. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Thus, the whole land shall learn that Israel has a God,
Father, your Son. Blessed be the Lord, never mock.
Blessed be the Lord, never mock.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my hand for battle, my fingers for war.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock,
my refuge and my fortress, my stronghold, my deliverer, my shield, in whom I trust, who subdues my people under me.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
O God, I will sing a new song to you. With a tinkling lyre, I will chant your praise. You who gives victory to kings and deliver David, your servant, from the evil sword.
Blessed be the Lord, my rock.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus preached the gospel of the kingdom and cured every disease among the people.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus entered the synagogue. There was a man there who had a withered hand. They watched Jesus closely to see if he would cure him on the Sabbath, so that they might accuse him. He said to the man with the withered hand, "Come up before us." Then he said to the Pharisees, "Is it lawful to do good on the Sabbath rather than to do evil, to save life rather than to destroy it?" But the man said, looking around at them with anger and grieved at their hardness of heart, Jesus said to the man, "Stretch out your hand." He stretched it out, and his hand was restored. The Pharisees went out and immediately took counsel with the Herodians against him to put him to death. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We continue looking at the different vocations that we have embraced, and the battles that we meet in all those vocations. There's no doubt, as human beings, we experience our own challenges. At times, those challenges or sufferings come from within or from without. We cannot be exempt from that just because we are Christians. And at times it becomes very, very hard even to avoid some of those battles, because at times they are a product of doing the good that you do. Someone can stand there and become envious of the good you do, and is going to pick war because of the good that you're doing, or for struggling to live your own Christian calling, your vocation. At times, it can lead you to battle. But at times, those battles also come from within, saying the ideal good and the temptations that you may encounter every day. The challenge is, where do I draw my strength? I invite you to focus on the psalm that we have just recited to identify one of the sources of strength that you and me, in the event of all those tensions within us, can be drawn. Blessed be the Lord, my rock, for you and me to realize that as our Christians, with all the challenges that we may meet as human beings, if we build our strength on God, then our battles will always be fought, not only using our own human strength, but using the strength that comes from above. Not relying on ourselves, but relying on the God who has called us and on the God that we confide. And we can see this in the example of the first reading, where David even was seen as a youth, a nobody, who had no experience in battle, but he had his own strength in God. He said, "You may come to me using all your power. You may come to me using all your experience. You may be as mighty as you are, but I come to you using the strength of the God who has called you, who has given you this mission." And that is how he overcame his battle. Jesus, in the gospel, we see he is surrounded by enemies. And at times, those we consider as enemies may not be foreigners, at times people that you move with, people who share in your company. And at times it becomes very, very frustrating and so depressing when you see people you are sharing the same experiences. At times you even share the same house. At times even your family members turn against you. What do you do as a human being? Do you compromise the good that you're supposed to do, just to make them happy? Jesus never did that. He knew all their own intention, but at the same time, he never just wanted to succumb to it. He followed the dictate of his own conscience. We know what the power of the conscience is. Something within you that tells you, this is good, go ahead and do it. This is bad, don't do. Do I compromise that inner power in me so that I can only make people happy? Or I follow the example of Jesus, even in the midst of all the external pressure and woes, that I may faithful to my Christian calling and I do what Jesus wants me to do? We want to pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that we may follow the example of Saint Anthony the Abbot, whose memorial is today, who denounced the world so that he could live in solitude in the desert, following his calling. That we may be inspired by him in the different battles to follow that inner voice and do what God demands of each one. For the church leaders, may the Holy Spirit continue to lead them in wisdom and truth as they shepherd God's people. We pray to the Lord.
The Lord hear our
prayers. For all who govern, may the Lord bless them with generous and charitable hearts. We pray to the Lord.
The Lord hear our prayers.
For all who are persecuted for their faith in Christ, may the Holy Spirit uphold and strengthen them in their darkest hours. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may the Lord, who is our refuge and strength, keep us free from all temptation and safe from all evil. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all that the Lord has called, marked with Christ's own sign, we remember Lawrence and Olaju Obameni. May they soon come to share the Christ's glory, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
We now take a moment over those prayers that line the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear prayer.
We ask for this from Christ our Lord. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
until you come.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Timothy our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Lawrence Okano, Blood and Olaji Obamedon, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that them who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, all we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Anton, the abbot, and all the saints who have praised you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Lord's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
And now let us offer each other the sign of peace. Love of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, enter my house.
Thank you.
sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine,
O
praise and all
thanksgiving.
Let us pray. Nourished for our healing by your sacraments, O Lord, may we escape every snare of the enemy and heart, just as by your grace, Saint Anthony won glorious victories over the powers of darkness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have one of us celebrating our birthday, so we are going to sing for her.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Thank you.